Thank you very much. Excellencies, dear colleagues, welcome to Bratislava. It's great to see so many of you here around this table. In the past 3 years, Slovakia has chaired nearly every international organization in our region, including the EU, UN General Assembly, V4, or the OECD. But I am told that this OECD Ministerial Council is in fact the biggest diplomatic exercise our city and our country has ever seen. Over 1,500 delegates from 57 participating states and 11 partner countries. It makes me think of the last time Bratislava was filled with this many international guests. And I think it was for the ice hockey championship earlier this year. But this time there is no victory from Finland to grab. This time Bratislava breathed the spirit of cooperation, not competition. It breathed the true spirit of Helsinki. That's where it all started almost 45 years ago, and that's where we always turn our minds at the OECD. I am actually the same age as the Helsinki Accords. Well, to be exact, I am 66 days younger. But since those hot days in Helsinki in the midst of Cold War, a lot has changed. In this country, in our region, and in the world. And even though I was of a young age, I belong to the generation that remembers. We remember the pain of division, when Helsinki felt oceans away from Czechoslovakia. We remember the thrill of freedom, when the walls fell down. What my generation of Slovaks thankfully does not remember is war. But millions of citizens of nations gathered around this table do remember. So we came here today because we believe that OECD still has a role to play in making this region better and safer for us and for the next generations, so that they do not have to remember the anguish of conflict and violence. Slovakia strongly believes in the OECD, and I know you do too, otherwise you would not be here today. OECD is historically unique. Where else do you find a platform to lead dialogue across three continents on a daily basis, system to check each other's elections, or hold each other to account on human rights standards? We believe in the story of Helsinki, and we believe in multilateralism. That's why we decided to offer our service to chair this organization, because it is not enough to say, I am a multilateralist. We need to fill this word with deeds. And in Slovakia, we saw our chairmanship as an opportunity to prove that we are ready to do more, to take the lead, to contribute in pursuit of peace and stability in our region. During that year, we saw a lot. We saw dialogue stumble, but also gain a new momentum. We saw instability in parts of our region, but also possible path to resolution. But first and foremost, we always tried to see people. People feeling abundant in the midst of crisis, but also people infused with hope, crossing the new bridges we built together, attending schools we helped to restore, recovering in hospitals we helped to equip. So if there is one thing I am especially proud of, one thing I hope our chairmanship will be remembered for, it is the focus on people. By that I mean, first, people suffering from conflict. We always try to see the big picture, to support political processes and make our region safer through dialogue. But we also try to use every opportunity to ease the situation for people who are paying the highest price of any conflict and instability. And I am glad we saw some encouraging steps lately. I want to thank all those who contributed to making the reparation of the breach on the line of conflict in Stanica Luhanska possible. Second, people who do not always have their voice heard. We always tried to be inclusive, fill the table with people of all nationalities or ages, men and women alike. For example, we brought central stage over 100 young people at the OECD Youth Forum in Bratislava for all across the region, from all across the region. And I want to thank all those who throughout this year lended their voices and spoke for the future they desire. And I want to assure you that we listened. And third, people who wear the OECD badge. We try to support all those who work daily for safer lives of us all, many times in dire conditions and under enormous risk. OECD monitors, mediators, people on the ground. I thank them all for the work and sacrifice they bring for our common good. And I also thank the chairperson in office, Miroslav Lajčák, for his personal commitment and for engaging with all of the OECD field. And I want to thank the whole team of our Ministry of Foreign and European Affairs and diplomats in Bratislava, Vienna, and all around the world for doing their best to advance the cause of the OECD. And I'm very grateful for individual contribution of each and every one of you. So, Excellencies, dear colleagues, our chairmanship is nearing its conclusion, but there is still so much more to be done in the OECD area. So, to the next chairmanship, I hope you will be successful. And I hope you build 10 bridges and bring 1,000 people around the table, because the OECD needs it, and we need it. So once again, dear friends, welcome to Bratislava. We are happy to have you here. And there are no cups to win this time, so the Finnish delegation can be at ease, but there is a consensus to reach. And to that, I wish you all energy, patience, and the spirit of compromise. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.